The NRA is under an all-out assault. Anti-gun forces are rallying, conspiring in an effort to destroy this great organization. We will not let it happen. Our engaged, passionate, patriotic membership will squash the hate coming at us. We have to. A little less than 2 years ago, the NRA held its annual meetings in Louisville, Kentucky. 80,000 freedom-loving Americans came together to celebrate the Second Amendment and to celebrate this great country. And let me tell you something. During those 3 days, crime dramatically dropped across the city. There were only 16 reports of crime compared to 102 just 2 weeks earlier. That's what happens when tens of thousands of law-abiding Americans come together to celebrate freedom. Everyone is safer. That is who the NRA is. But this week in Louisville, almost 2 years later, socialist vandals declared, quote, "Kill the NRA," graffitied onto a billboard next to the disturbing message, a tag for the radical group Resist 45, a group of underground violent socialists who use crime to oppose President Trump, to undermine freedom, and now to put targets on the backs of NRA members and gun owners. This, folks, is what we are up against. These people, these monsters, want to kill the NRA, and they want to do it so they can destroy America. Once you are disarmed, their violence will only escalate. You mark my words on that. We will not let that happen. But I need you. We need you, now more than ever. As freedom-loving Americans, as NRA members, we must come together to defeat this violent socialist wave. Because while celebrities, politicians, and the lying media continue to call NRA members terrorists, while they continue to push for the abolishment of the Second Amendment, they continue to tell each of us that we have blood on our hands. Why? Simply because we own guns. Simply because we exercise our constitutional right. I have not seen any of these Hollywood movie stars or politicians come out and denounce the sadistic message, "Kill the NRA," plastered on a billboard. Let me ask you this. If the message had read, "Kill Black Lives Matter," do you think Nancy Pelosi, Al Sharpton, radicals like Tamika Mallory, Linda Sarsour, and DeRay McKesson would be remaining silent right now? Of course not. Chris Matthews would have already accused every NRA member and Trump supporter of having paint on their hands. Instead of "Kill the NRA," if the billboard had read, "Kill the Women's March," do you think Chief Elizabeth Warren, Senators Chuck Schumer and Dianne Feinstein would be silent? Hell no. You better believe CNN, MSNBC, and the New York Times would have already given Olympic-style coverage to the billboard. Instead, there is nothing but silence on the issue. Why? Because their anti-gun rhetoric promotes these vandals to do what they do. But when it's the NRA, when it's rural America, when it's gun owners, when it's libertarians, conservatives, people who back our president, Americans who believe in the Constitution, saying they are going to kill us is perfectly acceptable. Well, not to me, because Joe Scarborough, Cory Booker, Joanne Reed and Meryl Streep, they don't need to paint to write this message. They declare it every day in how they cover us, how they look down at us, how they paint us as terrorists and bigots and people too stupid to make our own decisions. They don't just want to kill the NRA. They want to kill America. Folks, we don't just face radical, violent vandals. We are up against billionaires and the entire mainstream media, not to mention academia. So I'm asking you, get engaged. Even more than you already are, please. Taking back the truth, protecting the second, and fighting the left-wing madness will take a giant army of patriots. We have that army, and we can help defend freedom with your passion to take back the truth, to protect the Second Amendment. Because don't forget, you are the very people they want to kill. You are the NRA, and we are NRATV. And all of us together, committed to fighting the violence and lies with the fire of truth, we're not going anywhere. Our spirit can't be killed. And that, folks, is a guarantee.